subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeji Chonzo. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 2nd of September. India reports most COVID-19 cases in 2 months, worst hit Kerala state in focus. Kabul residents await new government in Afghanistan amid economic chaos. And Sri Lankan government denies food shortage amid forex crisis. And now for all the details. India logged 47,092 new COVID-19 cases on Thursday, the biggest single-day rise in infections in 2 months, taking the infections tally to 32.85 million. The most affected Kerala continues to be of particular concern as the southern state accounted for nearly 70% of the new cases in the last 24 hours.
India on Thursday reported 47,092 new infections in the last 24 hours, the biggest single-day rise in COVID-19 cases in 2 months, taking the caseload to 32.85 million with 439,529 deaths reported so far. This comes as the government worries about the virus spreading from the most affected Kerala state on India's southern tip, which has accounted for nearly 70% of the new infections a week after it celebrated its biggest festival, during which family and social gatherings are common. Meanwhile, more states on Thursday reopened schools for physical classes, mainly for middle school and above, after a months-long gap, despite apprehensions from some parents. Health experts have also warned laxity during the upcoming festive season can lead to a possible third wave, and following appropriate preventive measures is important.
In totality, अभी हम रिस्क से फ्री नहीं हैं. हमें सावधान रहना ही पड़ना है. और थर्ड वेव की भी पॉसिबिलिटी है. थर्ड वेव को नहीं आनी चाहिए. इसमें तो हम ही सब सहयोग करें कि वैक्सीनेशन लगवाएं और बाकी जो कोविड अप्रोप्रिएट बिहेवियर है उसको अपनाए रखें तो चांसेस हैं कि कंट्रोल रहेगा.
इंडिया इज ट्राइंग टू वैक्सीनेट अ बिग मेजॉरिटी ऑफ इट्स 944 मिलियन एडल्ट्स बिफोर अनदर कोविड वेव. सो फार 662 मिलियन डोजेस हैव बीन एडमिनिस्टर्ड विद एट लीस्ट वन डोज टू 54% ऑफ एडल्ट्स एंड द रिक्वायर्ड टू डोजेस टू 16%.
इन न्यूज फ्रॉम अफगानिस्तान. Residents in Afghan capital are waiting for the new government to be formed after the Taliban took over and US troops left earlier this week. The new rulers of Afghanistan are now preparing to unveil their government as the economy teetered on the edge of collapse, more than 2 weeks after the Taliban captured Kabul and brought a chaotic end to the 20 years of war.
The Taliban took over Afghanistan after the US troops left Kabul earlier in the week, leaving much of the country in chaos. Kabul residents said on Thursday they were waiting for the new government to be formed. Some residents said they were happy because thefts and extortion had come to an almost total standstill out of fear of the Islamic Emirate, as the Taliban call themselves. But others said their jobs and businesses had suffered a great deal in the past 2 weeks. Since the takeover, as many people have fled the country and economic activities, especially banking and public services, have been thrown into chaos. Afghanistan's Taliban rulers were preparing on Thursday to unveil their new government as the economy teetered on the edge of collapse, more than 2 weeks after the Islamist militia captured Kabul. Media reports have also surfaced that Taliban officials were holding talks with Qatari experts on the resumption of operations at the Kabul airport. On Thursday, activity at the airport was at a standstill. The legitimacy of the new government in the eyes of the international donors and investors will be crucial for the economy as the country battles drought and the ravages of a conflict. Meanwhile, Taliban officials have said the problems will ease once a new government is in place and have appealed to other countries to maintain economic relations. But the structural problems run deep.
In news from Pakistan, hundreds of Afghan families who have fled Afghanistan have set up makeshift tents in Pakistan's border town of Chaman. They said they feared a bleak future and economic uncertainty back home and have urged Pakistani authorities for help.
Hundreds of people who have fled Afghanistan along with their families in fear of a bleak future and economic uncertainty have set up makeshift tents near a railway station in Pakistan's border town of Chaman. They said they have shifted to Pakistan because back home there was no work to do and their children were all hungry. In an administrative vacuum in Afghanistan, prices have soared while Afghani currency has also tumbled. The Afghans urged Pakistani authorities along with compatriots to help them.
I among you nim sal kuruna di among dir pa bizati bande aw pa dir aga bande mung di aga na pa jan na waqt di khata aw mung sar dir zurmuna mushwar da mung dir sar yana da bandi pati di aw dir kardi ma da bandi pati di aw alta na rode paida ki da na hukum bo paida ki na khari wa na garib wa chim no mung da bi wasai da la sa dil tara majir shu dil tara majir shu mung sar bech ta su komo bo gai imdad ko mung sar aqbal da rana rahe mung
se majburi becharagi be wasle ra ma ija amadem ما از دولت پاکستان خواهش همی داریم که باید برای ما غریبا بیچاره باید که کمک شوه که نه سرپناه داریم نه جای نه ملک هیچ چیزی نداریم باید که همه درخواست ما از پلیس پاکستان از وطندارای خود از هر مردم باید که ما مدد میخواهیم که برای ما یک کمک شوه
Pakistan's Interior Minister Sheikh Rashid Ahmed had earlier on Monday said that Pakistan had not granted refugee status to a single person from Afghanistan until now, amid the evacuation of foreigners and Afghans following the Taliban takeover of Kabul. Pakistan is already home to 1.4 million Afghan refugees, according to UN Refugee Agency data. The number of undocumented Afghans is estimated to be much higher.
Moving on. Prominent Pashtun leader Mohsin Dawar and his colleagues in the Pashtun Tahafuz movement have formed a new political party called National Democratic Movement. Dawar, who is also the member of National Assembly, has long been a critic of Pakistani army, blaming it of ethnic stereotyping, enforced disappearances and fake encounters.
Member of National Assembly of Pakistan, Pashtun leader Mohsin Dawar and some of his colleagues in the Pashtun Tahafuz movement on Wednesday formed a new political party called National Democratic Movement or NDM. Addressing a press conference in Peshawar, the leaders of the NDM said they would strive for the establishment of the federal democratic parliamentary system in the country. They said they believe that Pakistan's constitution had given unjust powers to a province due to its large population, which was violating the rights of the smaller provinces and nationalities, and this needed to be rectified. The office bearers of the NDM include Mohsin Dawar as central organizer, Muzammil Shah as general secretary, and Jamila Gilani as information secretary, among others. Pashtun leaders have time and again accused that the members of their ethnic minority community have been targets of military operations, ethnic stereotyping and enforced disappearances and fake encounters by Pakistani security forces. They say the army, which has deployed troops in the Pashtun-dominated tribal areas, has in fact provided patronage to terrorists in carrying out attacks against the minority tribal population.
In news from Bangladesh, Bangladesh is witnessing a significant spike in dengue fever cases. The reemergence of dengue this year due to the mosquito-borne disease amid the coronavirus pandemic is a cause for huge concern. Hospitals and clinics in capital Dhaka are crammed with dengue patients. So far, 10,356 cases and 42 deaths has been registered this year.
Bangladesh has witnessed a significant spike in dengue fever cases in August, with 10,356 cases and 42 deaths registered so far this year, the Directorate General of Health Services, or DGHS, said this week. According to DGHS, by region, Dhaka and its neighboring districts are still more vulnerable to the risk of mosquito-borne diseases. Hospitals and clinics in Dhaka are cramped with dengue patients. Earlier this week, one of the largest public hospitals in Dhaka, Sir Salimullah Medical College Hospital, was seen flooded by hundreds of patients suffering from dengue fever, which is transmitted by several species of mosquito within the genus Aedes.
Hospital niye jay hospital rakhe na koyekta hospital e nay bhorti nay test kore onek gula test korar pore dengue rog dhore poreche ekhane seba jotno ja dise bhaloi dise ekhane motamoti ami shusthoi kintu ekhono bomi ta amar kome nay ar klanto.
Researchers warn that den 3 variant of the dengue virus is dominant in Bangladesh now, and contracting the strain after a previous infection could be fatal.
আগেতে যদিও পার্সেন্টেজটা কম কিন্তু এটা আশঙ্কাজনক বলা হচ্ছে যে এটা বেশি ডेंजरस আর আগে যাদের একবার ডেঙ্গু হয়ে গেছে তাদের যদি এবার হয় ডেন 3 দিয়ে তাহলে তাদের মারাত্মক হওয়ার একটা সম্ভাবনা আছে.
The re-emergence of dengue amid the coronavirus pandemic is a cause for huge concern.
Moving on to news from Sri Lanka. The Sri Lankan government on Thursday denied that the country was facing a food shortage, stating that the emergency regulations imposed on the supply of essential goods this week were to stop their hoarding. President Gotabaya Rajapaksa had on Tuesday promulgated the public security ordinance on the supply of essential goods, raising concerns that the country is facing a food shortage. The government spokesperson said certain media reports on the issue have no basis and stated the move came after some traders were hoarding commodities such as paddy, rice and sugar. Their aim is to seize such stocks and hand them over to state establishments for distribution at government mandated prices. In recent weeks, the prices of most essential commodities have been skyrocketing due to the falling local currency and high global market prices driven by COVID-19 pandemic. The island nation is currently under a 16-day curfew until September 6 because of a jump in infections. With the aim to bring Changthang region and its distinctive culture on the tourist map of India's northern Ladakh region, authorities here organized a two-day Ladakh nomadic festival this week. People of the Changthang plateau are nomadic pastoralists and their lifestyle and culture is similar to that of Tibetans. Ladakh, the Himalayan desert bordering China's Tibetan Autonomous Region, is a Buddhist-dominated union territory of India. Authorities in India's Ladakh organized a nomadic tribes festival this week to bring unique cultures and traditions of nomads of the easternmost Changthang plateau of the region on the tourist map, as well as provide a better platform to showcase it. The festival that focused on sustainable development witnessed the participation of several nomadic tribes and included events like cosplaying, singing, yak dancing, spinning, weaving, playing dice and other types of art.
जो भी हमने यहाँ पे किया है वो लद्दाख के नोमेडिक के आर्ट और कल्चर को प्रिजर्व करने के लिए हमारा एक क्या कहते हैं आप इन्वेस्टमेंट है और एक ऐसा इन्वेस्टमेंट जो आज पता नहीं चलेगा लेकिन बहुत सारे सालों के बाद ये याद रखा जाएगा और इसका जो महत्व है इम्पोर्टेंस है वो हम रियलाइज कर जाएंगे.
नोमैडिक फेस्टिवल दिस इज समथिंग वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग बिकॉज द वे दे ड्रेस एंड द फूड एंड द नोमैडिक कल्चर एंड द टेम्परेचर एवरीथिंग इज बहुत हमको बहुत डिफरेंट लगते हैं.
द टू डे फेस्टिवल ऑल्सो शोकेस कॉम्पिटिशंस लाइक आर्चरी एंड हॉर्स रेसिंग. The lifestyle and culture of nomads of Changthang Plateau is similar to that of Tibetans, and Ladakh region is also home to several Himalayan tribes. Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter @asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.